Welcome back to CCTV. On today's menu, highlights of the social event, an interview on the evolution of chemicals legislation in Asia, and breaking news on the location of ChemCon Europe 2018. But first we start with some sound bites from the sessions on REACH.
The Wednesday morning session on EU legislation and the legislation, similar legislation on Turkey, showed that, especially for the EU REACH part, the registration deadline 2018 is a really crucial step, but it's not the end of REACH, it's just the beginning. The following evaluation of all the information, especially for chemicals management purposes following up, like authorization, restriction, harmonized classification, triggered really an interesting discussion during that session.
Time to find out more about yesterday's social event. Ron, my man, what a great evening. Could you perhaps play a nice song to go along with an impression of the evening?
Oh, of course, TJ. We're going to play Do You Know What It Means to Miss New Orleans? Do you know what it means to miss New Orleans and missing a night at of ChemCon, the Americas 2018 marched together in a second line to the location of the social event, Marché, located in the French Market of New Orleans. Since 1791, the historic French Market has been an enduring symbol of pride and progress for the people of New Orleans. Around 1880, the market featured a butcher's market, a fruit and vegetable market, and a fish market. French, Italian, Spanish, Portuguese, Dutch, and gumbo were all offering great experience for foodies. As for the confusion of tones in the market, you might not understand what they said, but once it was on your tone, you knew it was simply delicious. Also yesterday, our delegates could sample all kinds of great dishes. And for those that wanted a glimpse in their future, there were tarot readers. Tarot doesn't have the power to change future events, but it can help you anticipate them. For those of you curious about the future, the location of the next ChemCon event was announced.
Great, we will connect again later in the bulletin to learn more about your breaking news on the location of ChemCon Europe 2018. That was yesterday. Today we will focus on Asia, a topic discussed in today's interview where we look into the evolution of chemicals legislation in Asia and the possible influences of EU REACH and US TSCA on these developments. In a week where athletes are competing for Olympic medals in Korea, we will look into the evolution of chemicals legislation in Asia and talk about possible influences of EU REACH and US TSCA on these developments. Which legislation is the most ambitious? REACH, TSCA, K-REACH or... Before jumping to conclusions, I will look into this interesting topic with Robert Kiefer from REACH24H and Herb Estreicher from Keller & Heckman. If either of you would be invited to develop a new legislation from one of the developing countries in Asia, which model would you think is most suitable, or which model would you invent?
I think most experts kind of point to the Canadian Chemical Management Plan as a model system. What they did with their categorization and screening of their domestic substance list or their inventory, where they basically prioritized, they went through their 23,000 chemicals and came up with a short list of 4,300 chemicals of which they would then do further evaluations, and they split it into three phases. And that, to many, is an ideal system. In addition, ICCA, the International Chemical Council Association, has a regulatory toolbox which they have developed for developing countries to implement chemical management systems, and so there's kind of a stepwise approach for them to do that. So, you know, if they were to utilize that in addition to, you know, looking at the Canadian system, and several countries did. I mean, U.S. TSCA in their reform kind of took that approach with the prioritization step.
And Herb, do you have an Asian dream for a legal framework?
Well, I mean, again, taking aside the countries that have a long history of chemical legislation, Korea, Australia, Japan, Taking those countries aside, I think for the other, and Taiwan now, I think for the other countries, probably the best thing they could do in terms of, because of limited resources, is they should have a strong pre-market manufacturing program or pre-importation program to ensure that new chemicals are reviewed before they go on the market. And in terms of existing chemicals, I would suggest that they simply look to see what Europe is regulating, what the U.S. is regulating, what Korea is regulating, et cetera, and say, well, are these chemicals used in our countries? Do these chemicals create a problem? Given local conditions, and if they do, then they should act accordingly. I don't see a need for them to structure their own REACH-type system.
Please watch the complete interview on our YouTube channel. Let's take a close look into one Asian country, Thailand, for the statement of the day. As mentioned earlier this week, ChemCon the Americas 2018 is our 25th ChemCon globally. The only person that has attended all of them is Karen Armstrong. In honoring Karen for her role as the founding mother of ChemCon, she can nominate one topic per conference which she feels deserves a spotlight in the APEC region, the Karen Armstrong APEC priority topic. For ChemCon the Americas 2018, Karen has selected Thailand. In today's statement of the day, we will shortly focus on Thailand with Karen and Ms. Somsui Suwanyaras from the Department of Industrial Works in Thailand. Ladies, welcome.
Thank you.
Karen, why did you choose Thailand?
In addition to having some of the best food in the world, Thailand is a country of increasing importance to industry. And as the industry grows, the regulations grow. We're very fortunate to have a government that reaches out to industry to get input. And especially in Thailand, they've reached out not only to local industry, but also to the international regulatory community.
Ms. Somsui, can you share with us how your government is encouraging industry input in the legislation?
Because of my department is under the Ministry of Industry, that responsible on all industry in Thailand. Every regulation that we issue is top up the safety measure to Thai industry. This is because of we concerning about the balancing between trade, safety and security. So the Thai industry have complied with all regulation. Before we issue each regulation, we have to hearing from the industry what their concern. And if we issue a very strict regulation and Thai industry cannot be complied with it, what happened?
Very good. And your statement is?
A good understanding of industry and local circumstance is helpful in developing a legal framework.
Ladies, thank you very much. And before we finalize with today's forecast, let's connect with Ron. Ron, the French market offered sweeping views of your majestic Mississippi River. I suggest we take a boat trip aboard one of the paddle wheelers all the way to Europe. Can you play Rolling on the River from Tina Turner?
Oh, it'd be my pleasure to do that. I've toured so many years with Tina when I was living in Los Angeles, working with Little Richard, and I've heard that song many, many nights. Well, I left a good job in the city, working for the men every night and day. But I never lost a minute of sleep. Thank you.
Budapest, wow! From the crescent city along the Mississippi to the pearl of the Danube. Exciting! That's the forecast for November, now the forecast of today. This morning we focus on Asia, with China, Japan, Malaysia, Thailand, Southeast Asia and India. And in the afternoon, more Asia-Pacific with Australia, New Zealand and Taiwan, followed by Russia. Our grand finale today, the global approach to new chemicals and polymers. Thank you for watching and have a great day.